for those of you who have been wanting to learn Lingala, to teach your kids Lingala, bring them in, bring them in. Auntie Feli is going to teach them everything they need to know, okay? What's up, family? My name is Felicity and welcome to Congo Talks 243. So you guys have been bothering me for a long time now to give you more language classes, more language lessons. So that's what we're going to do because you said so and we're gonna do that. So in today's video, I am going to teach you a few vocabulary that you may use in a market situation. Let's say you're going to the market to buy a few stuff. These are some words that you will hear. Okay, they're not just words. They could be verbs or they could be nouns. You know, they could be names of things. Without further ado, let's go to the point. Let's get started. So our first term today is kosomba. Kosomba. Kosomba means to buy. And again, every word that I am calling that starts with ko is a verb. So if you want me to conjugate all these verbs, let me know in the comment. Second term is Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola. It's like you're saying Coca-Cola, but it's Coca-Cola, okay? Coca-Cola means to bargain, okay? If you think the price that they've given you is too much and you want to bargain, you want to discuss the price with the seller, you are doing Coca-Cola, all right? You are bargaining. Our third one is kolinga. Kolinga. Kolinga means to want. So if you want something, it's like if you want to buy something, you know, that is the verb that you would be conjugating. Kolinga. Our next term is komema. Komema. Komema means to carry. Like in a situation where you want someone to help you carry your groceries, for example, to the car, that is the verb that you will be conjugating. It is kumema. Our next term is kopona. Kopona. Kopona means to choose. Like you want to choose which vegetable to buy, all right? So that is kopona. Our next term is kosimba. 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 Kosimba means to hold. A situation where you may use this maybe when you are choosing different vegetables. I know that I'm using vegetables a lot, but I hope you get the point. You may use this in a situation where you have different, you know, when they tie vegetables together and you want to choose which one you want to take. So if you want to hold them so you know how much, you know, how much it weighs or something, when you are holding them, then this is the verb that you will be using. Kosimba. Our next term is kolakisa. Kolakisa. Kolakisa means to show. If you want to get the seller to show you something, or like, show me that one. So the verb that you will be conjugating is kolakisa. Our next term is koteka. Koteka. Koteka means to sell. All right? So again, if you are the one who's selling something, you are, you know, you are conjugating the verb koteka. Our next term is kotala. 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 Kotala means to see. So if you want to ask like, let me see that one, it means you are conjugating the verb kotala. Our next term is kofuta. Kofuta. Kofuta means to pay. So if you want to pay for something that you are buying, that is the verb that you are conjugating. It is the verb kofuta. Now, I think we are done with our verbs related to market. Now, I'm going to call out a few objects that you may buy in a market. Our first one is mafuta. Mafuta. Mafuta means oil. If you're going to buy oil, that is what you're buying. In Lingala, it is mafuta. Our next one is mbisi. 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 Mbisi means fish. So if you're going to buy fish, that is how you call it in Lingala. Mbisi. Our next term is nyama. 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 Nyama means meat. If you're going to buy like goat meat, you say nyama ya ntaba. Okay, goat in Lingala is ntaba. But meat in general is just Nyama. Now, one thing to note about the word nyama is it is also used to say animal, okay? So nyama means animal or meat. But if you're talking about meat, then you have to say nyama ya something. Our next term is nguba. 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 Nguba means peanuts. If you're going to buy peanuts, then that's what you call it in Lingala. Nguba. Our next term is mbuma. 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 Mbuma means fruit. All right? So if you're going to buy fruit, then that is what you're going to call them. Mbuma. Now, it depends on what fruit you are going to buy. Different fruits have different names. So you could either choose to call them mbuma ya something. Like, for example, if you are going to buy oranges, you may say that mbuma ya lilala or malala. If you don't want, you could just call them malala or lilala. So you have a choice in that way. But fruit in general are called mbuma in Lingala. Our next term is sukali. Sukali. Sukali means sugar. If you're going to buy sugar, this is how you call it in Lingala. Sukali. Our next term is tangawisi. 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 Tangawisi means ginger. If you're going to buy ginger, this is what you call it in Lingala. Tangawisi. Our next term is ndunda. 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 Ndunda means vegetables. All right? If you're going to buy vegetables, this is the term that you will use. Ndunda. Our next term is masanga. Masanga. Masanga means alcohol or any alcoholic drink. If you're getting beer or wine or anything with alcohol, that's what you call it. Masanga. Our next one is mungwa. 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 Mungwa means salt. If you're going to buy salt, this is the term you will use in Lingala. It is mungwa. And now our last, but definitely not the least, is pilipili. Pilipili. Pilipili means chili or pepper. I think that's what you guys call it. Pepper. let's just call it chili, okay? Because if you're going to buy chili, this is the word that you will use. Pilipili. So that was all for today's video, guys. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. Let me know in the comment if you enjoyed this video. Oh, and one more thing, guys. I have a website running. I would invite you guys to check it out. I would actually leave it in the comment section. I will pin a comment with it, or I will... It's always on my channel anyway, and I will leave it in the description as well. So take a tour. I'm still getting it. It's very simple. It's a very simple website, but just have a look and let me know. Give me some feedback. I would really love that. And yeah, thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.